Randomized trials demonstrate that endovascular reperfusion therapy is better than medical therapy for treating many patients with acute ischemic stroke due to large vessel occlusion. A 2016 meta-analysis suggested greater benefit with earlier treatment, but the finding was based on data from only about 500 patients who were highly selected to meet trial inclusion criteria. The trials and subsequent studies were underpowered to determine associations between more precise time-to-treatment increments and patient outcomes. To estimate the benefit more precisely, researchers analyzed data from the U.S. Get With the Guidelines Stroke Registry, a large practice-based dataset detailing the care of patients with stroke and transient ischemic attack. They report their findings in the current issue of JAMA. 6,756 patients with acute ischemic stroke had complete data available and were included in the study. The patients underwent endovascular reperfusion therapy within 8 hours of symptom onset. 8 hours was a generally accepted time window for thrombectomy during 2015 and 2016, which was the study period. The researchers measured time to treatment two ways: as symptom onset to arterial puncture, or as hospital arrival to arterial puncture. They assessed a variety of clinical outcomes. Okay, let's move on to the results. The study findings confirmed the time-benefit relationship previously established in clinical trials. Shorter time to endovascular reperfusion therapy was associated with better outcomes. But the study also found that the time-to-outcome association was non-linear. Up to 4.5 hours after symptom onset, all clinical and adverse event outcomes were better with faster treatment. Among these, for every 15-minute decrease in time between symptom onset and puncture, there was a higher likelihood of achieving independent ambulation at discharge, lower in-hospital mortality or hospice discharge, and lower symptomatic intracranial hemorrhage. Here's what the absolute increases and decreases translate to. Among every 1,000 patients treated, every 15-minute decrease in onset to puncture time was associated with 11 more patients ambulating independently at discharge, 8 fewer patients being discharged to a hospice or dying prior to discharge, and 2 fewer patients with symptomatic intracranial hemorrhage. But these associations were observed only up to 4.5 hours. After 4.5 hours, the time benefit decline was less rapid. Faster hospital arrival to puncture times were similarly associated with improved outcomes, but with a nonlinear change at around 2 hours rather than 4.5 hours. Among these, in the 2-hour window, every 15-minute decrease in arrival to puncture time was associated with a higher likelihood of achieving discharge to home, amounting to 21 more patients per 1,000, and lower in-hospital mortality or hospice discharge, amounting to 15 fewer patients per 1,000. These findings reinforce the idea that shorter time to endovascular reperfusion therapy is associated with better outcomes. The larger and more diverse population in this study allows for more precise and generalizable estimates of time to treatment benefit. The study therefore emphasizes the importance of policies to accelerate the start of endovascular therapy in appropriately selected patients. To read the study, click the link in the description.